Hello all, today we are going to create the alarms and trends in WinCC. To go to the tag management, as usual in every SCADA you have to create a tag. You can see these kind of things are the system generator tags. We have to add our own tag, which I'm going to name as A. And that will be analog so that we can do it as unsigned 32-bit value. Then our tag has been created and go to the tag logging. First, for the trends or the online trends, we have to log the tag. So go to the process value archives, you can double click on that and you can create an archive name, which is ARCH archive 1. And inside that we have to double tap on the archive 1. Inside that we have to create the tag or integrate the tag for the archive 1. For getting the tag value, we can log the tag value in the online trends. So this will take some time. And you can see A is here, our tag, and hit OK. You can see the analog tag name is A. And just go to the alarm logging. So tag logging has been completed and we will go to the alarm logging. Alarm logging, inside that we can see that analog alarms. Inside that we have to create the analog alarms, high and low limits. So double tap on the analog alarms and go to place the tag first. Inside that you can see the A is our tag and hit OK. And again you can see the message number as I'm giving as 1. The comparison is high limit and the comparison value I'm giving as 80 and above. So the comparison limit will be 80 and above. And also I have to add a new, it's the same tag A, or add from here A, and the message number will be 2, which will be the low limit. So I have to add the low limit. You can see, you can assign this low limit values, same values, different, any kind of comparison you can add, and the comparison value will be 20. I'm using the high and low alarms A and A, the high limit and low limit. And I can go to the alarm message from here, comparison value tag, and you can see all the messages will go to the message number or the message label, message group, message text. You can say, set the message text as high value, HIGH high value, and the second one as low. That will be the message text. That's it. And minimize this. You can go to the graphics designer. Before that, we have to enable all those things. Go to the computer and right click on this. Go to the properties. You can click on the startup and you have to enable the alarm logging runtime and the tag logging runtime. And hit OK. Then we can go to the graphic designer. And here we got our graphic designer, and close everything on the bottom, and you can go to the display library. Go to the display library, inside the operation you'll get the slider. So you can see the slider here and drag the slider 1. So click and drag the slider 1 and we can double tap, or first close the library and place the slider on the leftmost side, double tap. You can see the tag assignment. Tag assignment, we have to go to the process, double tap on the process and change it to 0. Otherwise the slider will be starting from 50. So I'm going to right click on the process and tag I have to assign as A. Our created tag is A, analog tag. And the update will be happening in upon change. Then we have to go and place the alarm control and the online trend control. From here you can get the online trend control, and the tag name I am assigning as inside the archives A, and hit OK. Archive 1 A has been done, and the trend color I can choose like black or green, any color I can choose. and the limit values, like the low limit value will be, I can choose the color as red, and okay, that high limit value I'm using the choosing the color as blue. Okay, the intermediate limit will be something like green. So the high limit is 100 value have done, and hit okay. The active alarm has been completed. Then you have to place the trend control, sorry, the alarm control. Open the alarm control, and nothing to configure in this, just go to the message list and click on this arrow and place the message text, point of error, everything, and hit OK. That's it. Expand it and place here, and that's it. This alarm trends is auto configurable, so the range will be automatically adjusted. So then we can go to the runtime and go and save this, and the process to be activating the SCADA will take some time. And here we got the WinCC runtime. You can see the value is now it is zero. The slider value is zero, though, so that is running like the red color. I'm changing the values like this 20, and you can see this tag has been raised, and also I'm raising it to the top, and that will be in blue color. Okay, that is the real-time trends. During that time, you can see the high alarm has been triggered. So I can acknowledge, single acknowledge. You can see, you can acknowledge these alarms. And also, so in this WinCC trend control, you can see that that value has been ranged automatically. So it is 0 to 100. That ranging has been done automatically. So I'm reducing it to the negative values or the below 20. It's 19. Now you can see the low alarm has been triggered. So you can acknowledge, group acknowledgement, click on that, you can see that every alarms will be acknowledged. That is the alarms and trends in the WinCC. In this, in between the 80 and 20, there is no alarms because it is a healthy range. So increasing again, you can see the high alarm has been triggered. That is the WinCC alarms and trends. So thanks for watching.